Welcome to the second episode of Coffee or Tea, brought to you by the Young Executive Society of CAPH. My name is Christy Bell, and I'm the Bronte Collection Manager with OS&B. And here with us today, we have Brad Cornelison, the National Sales Manager of OS&B. Welcome, Brad.
Hi, guys. Thanks for having me. I'm excited to be interviewed today in this new and exciting format.
Well, we're excited to have you here today, too, and learn a little bit more about you and your experiences in the industry. Before we get started, we're going to do a little warm-up. We're going to do some this or that questions just to kind of get us in the mood, and then we're going to move on to some more industry-specific questions. So, Brad, can you tell me your preference between hockey or baseball?
That's an easy one. Hockey for me, 100%.
And dare I ask your favorite team?
The Leafs. We're actually doing really well this year, but hopefully if they win the Cup, there's no asterisks placed beside it for a COVID Stanley Cup.
Oh, yeah, I agree with that. Okay, moving on. Sweet or salty? What's your preference?
Both. I'm a Costco member, and who doesn't love Chicago mixed popcorn? So
I
agree on that one.
I agree with you completely on that. How about a comic book question? Superman or Batman?
My son is a Batman nut, and his room is covered in Batman, so I'm going with Batman.
Good choice. Good choice. Music genre, pop music or rock music?
I think that one's a it depends answer. It depends. I could listen to any music depending on who I was with, where I'm listening to it. So it's situational for me. If I was at a concert, I'd probably prefer rock. And if I was singing in the shower in the morning, I'd probably listen to pop.
It's a good way to start your day with some pop music. I agree. And social media side of it, TikTok or Instagram?
I'm Instagram. I haven't fully perfected the floss yet, but when I do, I will get on TikTok.
I find myself scrolling through TikTok. It's interesting the way it captivates you with the videos rather than the pictures.
They are both addictive for sure.
Definitely. Okay, well, thanks for that. Now I'm going to move into some more industry-specific questions and pertaining to you and your role in the industry. So are you ready?
I am ready.
Good. Okay, so how long have you been in the plumbing industry and where did you get your start?
I started with a company called Van Hoot Cafe. They're an office coffee service based out of Toronto. They've been since bought by Green Mountain Coffee. My first role was installing office coffee makers, water coolers into a lot of office towers downtown Toronto. So that was in the year 2000. Loved the industry, and then had a unique experience with my dad purchasing OS&B in 2005. And in 2006, I moved into a traditional core manufacturer of the plumbing industry, after running into a product that was actually installed in one of the office towers. I said, hey, you know, here's a beautiful opportunity to work with family for one, to get into a fantastic industry that I already knew. And I jumped at the opportunity, and in 2006, I moved to OS&B and started in the warehouse. And that included in the packaging and assembly department. So I got to know the intimate workings of the operation from the ground floor, and been lucky enough to move throughout the organization to try quite a few different roles. So it's been quite a fantastic ride, and still love doing it every day. So
awesome! So you've been here a while, and you're still here, so that's a good sign. So that's a good segue into your role at OS&B. What's your favorite thing about being a national sales manager?
We're a small to medium-sized enterprise, so the role is a little more encompassing than the title. So my favorite part is being an influence on all aspects of the business, and that may be from product design, product development, working with directly with our wholesale customer partners, also with plumbing contractors and mechanical contractors. So the variety, I would say, is the biggest benefit that I find in my role. That's something that I enjoy, of wearing multiple hats, being able to have a different day almost every day. So that's my fave.
I have to agree. I love not doing the same thing every day. And I find that in sales, it's a really great way to switch things up and, you know, have a new day every day, which is awesome.
People at the end of the day, dealing with people is the most fun. And a lot of the time you're meeting new people, which is also a lot of fun. And they could be from all walks of life and all areas of North America, and getting to hear their experiences and how they get to deal with your organization. So people at the end of the day and experience.
Absolutely. I agree with that. So I'm going to move into another question about the world we live in today. And as we know, COVID has had a significant impact on our industry and changed the way that salespeople do business and interact with their customers. When it's safe to start traveling again, how do you foresee the pandemic and how will it change the dynamic of the outside salesperson and how they conduct their business?
I think that's a very interesting question. A lot of people are looking for the answer or insight. And as with most things in life, I think we will come to find that new normal. The aspect of being face-to-face with people, I think, has been exacerbated by this experience we've all been through. COVID, I can say personally, the one thing that I miss the most is being around friends, family, colleagues. So being in front of people and person to person will still remain to be a important aspect of the outside salesperson's role. Where I think there may be a change is effectiveness and efficiencies of maintaining relationships. I personally can find and have found that establishing new relationships have been challenging while distributed. But where I think the video conferencing will remain and be strong is maintaining relationships and maintaining and growing efficiencies within the organization. So I think there's a duality or a hybrid model that will be a success going forward. And it'll just be time and effort to find out what that looks like in the near future.
Yeah, I have to agree with you. There's some definitely pros and cons with the way this world has changed. So the pro being, you know, family and being able to spend a little bit more time with our loved ones, and you know, the con being we're a bit disconnected in the way we communicate now. So, I foresee a hybrid as well.
Yeah, well, we can move on. To dive back into the topic again. At the end of the day, I think people in general buy and deal with brands that they trust. And I think that the in-person interactions will still be the go-to way of establishing trust or growing trust. Whereas once the trust has been established, that's where the efficiencies of technology can come into play. But I would imagine that once things do open up in the coming months, that travel will be hot and heavy, and it'll be a very interesting landscape to try and navigate. But this is the new and exciting world that we've had an inflection point, and that was March of 2020, where our world changed for everybody. And I think that's a common aspect that we all share going forward. And hopefully there's a little more empathy towards one another. And once we get to see each other, hopefully the hug becomes the new handshake.
Yeah, I agree with you. And I have to say, I cannot wait to get on that next plane ride.
Likewise.
Looking forward to that. So that's another good segue into the next question, because we're going to talk a little bit about personal and work-life balance. So being that we're all working at home and we're spending a lot more time being very connected to our industry and being available, let's say, how would you say you manage that work-life balance with your family at home, and how do you turn it off at the end of the day?
We made a couple attempts on a work-life balance, and one method was when I was traveling to the office. At the end of the day, I left my phone in a bin at the front door. Being a older millennial, I still had a pull to pick up the device during the evening. So I would say there is a very very difficult challenge between finding the balance. One thing that I do is, and I found it to be successful, is I schedule all important events in my calendar. So If there's school or sporting events or birthdays that I'm present, I'm committed to being 100% focused on the family, where work can wait till later. I personally think at the end of the day and the end of the career, not many people sit there and write in their eulogies that they wish they spent more time in the office. It's usually more time with your family. So whatever you can do to find that happy place and that balance between a successful career and a successful family life is a good life. So balance is tough, but once found, it's happiness.
I agree with that. Okay, one more question before we sign off here. I'm going to ask something really simple. What can you tell us that we may not already know about Brad Finlayson?
Well, I went through the memory box and I could only find a couple of things that were available for broadcasting. And one thing that came up was, and I don't think I've told many people, I was born in Halifax, Nova Scotia in the early 80s as my dad was stationed there as a traveling salesman with EMCO Factory Division. We moved back to Ontario in the mid 80s, but I got my start down east, and it still has some pull to my heart where who knows, one day I could end up there in retirement. So that's a long, long ways away, but there's something nice about down east that there's a different pace of life that I love.
I have to agree with you. I love the East Coast. It's a great group of people there, and I enjoy my time there as well.
Yeah, lots of fun. Halifax is a great city. If you ever get up to Cape Breton to do the Cabot Trail, that's an amazing trip. And then Newfoundland, there's extended family in Newfoundland, and that's a whole other ball of fun.
It sure is. All right, Brad. Well, thank you so much for your time today. I think we all learned a little bit more about you and gained some insights into, you know, the industry from your perspective, which was nice. So that's a wrap. Thank you so much for joining us today. And everyone, stay tuned for the next episode of Coffee or Tea, which you should see next month. Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.
Thanks, guys. Take care.